Hello and welcome to our Wonderstitcher Fairytale channel. This is where you'll see my partner and I stitch together a fairy tale comprised of some weird, delicious, edible creation, an original story, and of course the beautiful photographs to tie it together. We've shared several different parts of this project, from making these prop mushrooms to the makeup and the crown for the photo shoot. And this week, I'm so excited to finally share the edible version, the recipe of edible Amanita Muscaria mushroom cookies. So let's head to the kitchen. One thing you'll notice as we move through this series is that I like to add unusual flavors to recipes as a secret ingredient, something to set them apart and make them a little bit special. I started with a basic recipe for a gluten-free gingerbread base, but I added a bunch of lime zest, and I'm adding a lot of coconut flavors as well throughout the process. Into the wet mix goes a mixture of gluten-free flours and coconut flour, which adds a little bit of that flavor. Then it's time to wrap the dough tightly and chill it at least overnight. Gluten-free dough really benefits from a long time chilling. I'm using this gingerbread dough to form nice, large, dome-shaped caps. Then after baking, they're nice and soft for a little while, so I carve out the center of them. As you can see, I'm using a melon baller to create a line about a quarter inch from the edge, which I then very carefully and gently scoop out. It's best to scoop slightly away from or with the edge rather than towards it. And it's a little bit finicky, so if you mess up the first one, don't worry, you can just eat the cookie. It's delicious. By the way, one of my inspirations for this project was the lovely Amy of Twig Studios on Instagram. I love her creativity, and I learned this particular technique of creating gills on mushrooms from her, so I'll be sure to add her details in the description of the video. Here's another little close-up of how I'm scooping around the edges of that cookie, being really careful not to go through that barrier that I created. It's easiest to do this when the cookies are slightly warm, but still cool enough to hold in your hand. Next, it's time to mix up some royal icing. I added lime juice to mine to give it a nice kick to balance out the sweetness of the cookies. And then I used gel food coloring to dye it a nice, bright, orangish yellow. We generally think of Amanita muscarias as being red mushrooms, but they actually come in a wide range of colors, from white to yellow to red to orange. So I'm just trying to create a nice earthy orange to begin with. When I was happy with both the color and the consistency of my icing, I covered a couple of mushroom caps in the orange color, and then I added more red coloring to the frosting so that I could get a gradient of colors. Each color I used, I saved out a little bit for later, and you'll see why. Then it's time to let those icing drips dry overnight or until they're fully dry. I then went in with a little extra gel food paste and colored the center of the mushrooms a little bit darker red to make them look even more realistic, blending the edges with a brush and then letting that dry completely as well. I found that creating really realistic bakes is all about noticing the details. And one of the details I've noticed about these mushrooms is that they tend to be darker in color in the middle. After the additional painting dried, it was time to trim off any of the excess icing that had dripped down beyond the edge. I wanted a nice clean edge for the next step. While the caps were drying, I whipped up some edible gingerbread cookie dough with that lime zest added and grabbed some gluten-free pretzel rods and started forming these drumstick shapes to use as the stalks of our mushrooms. My dog was unimpressed. He thought we should be snuggling. I wanted to incorporate both baked gingerbread and gingerbread cookie dough for a contrast of textures and just for fun. After sculpting the drumsticks, I chilled them in the freezer until solid. Then I started coating them in white chocolate candy melts. At this step, it's better to have too much chocolate than not enough, because you can always shave off more later. The white chocolate really balanced out the intensity of the gingerbread and the salty crunch of the pretzels nicely. Once I had finished dipping each stalk, I stuck them upside down in a piece of styrofoam to chill completely. You can also use a cup full of beans or something like that, but I found the styrofoam to be the easiest option. Once they had fully set up, which didn't take too long because of the frozen base, I just very gently shaped them with a vegetable peeler. You want to be really gentle doing this as they're quite fragile. Just shave off any like weird lines or ridges so that you have a nice smooth stock bottom. Then I just use the warmth of my hands to smooth it out even further. The bulbous bases of Amanita muscaria often have some lines around them, so I'm just using some leftover white chocolate to draw on some of those lines and let them chill. Once cooled, I very gently cut the pretzel rods off at the length that I wanted each stalk to be by using a serrated knife and cutting gently in several directions till they popped off. And now it's gill time. I put a thin coat of white chocolate in the bottom of each of those cookie caps and let it set up just to form a solid base to work on. Then I piped a little bit of melted white chocolate about a third of the way around and started sticking in coconut flakes, tearing them to size so that they fit in as evenly and neatly as possible. You only want to work on about one third of the cap at a time so that the chocolate doesn't harden up before you have a chance to stick the coconut in. I love that this technique adds both really incredible texture and flavor to these cookies. Gingerbread, lime, and coconut are a fantastic combination. And look how cool they look once you start getting the gills all in place. Now it's time to add the bases to those cookies. So you blob in a nice big blob of white chocolate in the middle and stick a cookie base in it. Then use whatever you have around to prop them up. I use spice containers and jars of mushrooms. For a little extra realism on those bases, I used a clean paintbrush to paint melted dark chocolate on the bases and then dipped them into dried flaked coconut to add a little bit of texture. Then, using the tints of icing that I had set aside, I piped a nice clean circle covering the gingerbread around the base of each piece. Then, I very gently used damp fingers to kind of feather the edges and blend them in. I allowed that icing to set while I made the spots. I rolled out a little piece of fondant really thin and let it dry overnight, then tore it into uneven, kind of circular shapes. I used white chocolate to glue those into place so they looked like the most realistic pattern of an Amanita muscaria mushroom cap. Because of how the dots crack and spread as the Amanita cap opens up, I found that usually there are larger dots in the middle and then smaller dots spaced out more around the perimeter. An Amanita wouldn't be fully dressed without its frill, so I cut half circles out of edible rice wafer paper and then used just a little tiny bit of moisture to attach them together to form a little skirt. It's finicky work because if you use too much moisture, you can dissolve the piece, so be sure to use just a very lightly damp brush for this. Once dried, I added a little bit of texture to those skirts by cutting in some slits with sharp scissors. Then I piped a little white chocolate around the top to secure it in place and used my clean finger to blend it both into the stock and into the paper frill. To give the base of the mushrooms the look that they'd just been pulled from moss, I used high quality matcha powder and I really just laid it on there. I wanted to evoke that nice bright green of the rainforest that I often find these mushrooms in. And that's it! Look at those realistic, beautiful, delicious Amanita sculptures. So happy. And here they are on set at our photo shoot. They were almost indistinguishable from the foam mushrooms we made. But don't worry, this one's edible. Let's see what my fiance thinks of it. And by the way, you can find this recipe today on our Patreon, or wait until the project is completed. Happy wiggles. That's a good sign. Looks like they passed inspection. So glad.
Thanks for coming along for this journey. Don't forget to like and subscribe if you want to see more of our fairy tale content. And stick around because next week I'll be sharing the final compilation of this project, the edited photos plus the story that inspired all of this. I hope you'll come join us for that. Until then, magic always.